Good morning, everyone. It's showing to be 11 o'clock, so it's about time for us to get started. I'd like to welcome all of you to our services today at the First United Methodist Church of Muleshoe. Special welcome to everyone in the sanctuary, and a special welcome to our audience on Channel 6. And I'd like to also go ahead and take the opportunity to say a happy Father's Day to all you father types out there. First off, I'd like to make the announcement to let's all be sure and make every effort we can to help express our gratitude for Brooke's year of pastoral service here next Sunday. This week's announcements kind of come down to women's group 5:30 tomorrow or 5:30 tomorrow, men's Bible study on Tuesday, and then the Bible study Wednesday at noon. Are there any other announcements that need to be made today? Okay, well, if you would, let's turn to the Lord in prayer. Our gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for this beautiful day. We thank you for your many blessings and the gifts that you have bestowed upon us. We ask your special blessings, of course, today on the fathers, those that are with us and those that are with you at this time. We ask that you be with all of us as we go through this next week. Help us to do thy will and keep us in your blessings. All this we ask in Christ's name. Amen.
Okay, would you please rise and join with us as we sing song 89, Joyful, Joyful, We Adore Thee.
Joyful, joyful, we adore thee, God of glory, Lord of love. Hearts unfold, life bars before thee, opening to the sun above. Melt the clouds of sin and sadness, drive the dark of doubt away. Give her of immortal gladness, fill us with the light of works with joy surround thee, earth and heaven reflect thy rays, stars and angels sing around thee, center of unbroken praise, field and forest, vale and mountain, flowery meadow, flashing sea, chanting bird and flowing fountain, call us to ever blessing, ever blessed, wellspring of the joy of living, ocean depth of happy rest. Thou our Father, Christ our brother, all who live in love or thine, teach us how to love each other, lift us to the joy divine.
Okay, you may be seated.
Good morning, church.
Morning.
If you would, let's gather together as a people in prayer. Would you calm your minds and your hearts with me today? Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, we gather in your presence. We ask now, Holy Spirit, that you will search our hearts. If there's anything that stands between us, anything, any vice, any distraction, any habit, bring them to our minds so that we may confess, receive forgiveness, and walk in new life and obedience. Take this time. confess your sins to Jesus Christ. Now ask Jesus to help you turn away. Hear the words, in the name of Jesus Christ, and the church said, you are forgiven. We love you, Lord, for who you are and what you've done for us in your life, death, resurrection, and ascension. We thank you, Father and Son, for sending the Spirit to be with us. We love you and trust you in all that we are, in who we are, in a community, in a broader community, our town, like Muleshoe. Lord Jesus, we ask now that you will help us intercede on behalf of others and ourselves. If there's a concern you'd like to lift up, please do so, and if I can hear you, I will echo. Lord Jesus, we ask that your Holy Spirit will fill our community of faith. Fill Muleshoe, F-U-M-C. Fill the people called Methodist. Let us be beacons of light. Let us show the way to you, Father. Let us be Jesus Christ in our community. Give us Holy Spirit baptized power. Lord, when we pray for the sick, let them in Jesus' name be healed. When we serve the poor, serve the needed, let them experience the gospel. Lord Jesus, we pray for your church around the world. We pray for steadfast obedience in the face of persecution. We pray for our denomination. We pray for our leaders, who will seek truth above unity, a false unity. We pray for our country's leadership. Give our president and those who are serving at the highest levels wisdom that they do not have, that can only come from you. And Lord Jesus, finally, we ask that you will work through us, in us, and despite us, just as we have prayed and you have taught us to pray. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom and the power and the glory forever. Amen. Would you stand as we continue to worship through the giving of our tithes and gifts? Would you stand?
Children, please come forward and join Cheyenne up here for Children's Corner this morning.
Oh, good morning. You guys were hidden in the back. I'm so excited. How are we this morning? Good. I don't know that I've met you guys before. What are your names? What is it? Oh, cool. I like that name. What's your name? Oh, I love those names. Y'all are so cute. Okay, cool. Oh, they're your cousins. Well, welcome to Muleshoe. Awesome. I'm so glad to meet all of you guys. Okay, so today's a very important day. What is today? Father's Day. Good job, Case. He should get brownie points, right? Alrighty. So, since it is Father's Day, I brought a couple of things that remind me of a father. Does anybody know what this is? It's a wrench. I was expecting just a tool, but he's even more specific than that. A wrench. Cool. And what is this used for? Okay, cool. So maybe to like fix things. Dads are pretty good at that, aren't they? Fixing things. Some dads break things, but that's okay. Most of them are pretty good at fixing things. Okay. And what about this right here? What's this? A football. What do I use this for? Playing football. Who's someone who always, every single time you ask, hands down, will always play football with you or catch? Right? Oh, he doesn't use it very much? That's okay. Well, usually dads will play catch with you, so this made me think of a dad. And then, what about this? Money. We all know what this is, right? Dad, can I have $2 so I can get the Snickers bar from the concession stand? Yes. Money's for daddies? Yeah, they usually have some. Okay, so with that being said, the Bible tells us, hold on 1 second, I'll come back to you, okay? The Bible tells us that Jesus is also our Father. Did you know that? How awesome that we get to be blessed with not one awesome dad, but two awesome dads. Isn't that so cool? Awesome sauce. Okay, let's go ahead and say a prayer together. Normally I'd have you guys repeat after me, but this one I found, and I think it's really appropriate for Father's Day, and I think it'll be a good one. So let's just bow our heads and pray. Thank you, Jesus, for dads. They are very important, and we are so grateful for all that they do. Also, thank you for all of the people that look after us and care for us. We also want to thank you, God, because all of us have you as a wonderful Heavenly Father. In Jesus' name, amen. All right.
Thank you, Cheyenne. Okay, it's time for our blessings this morning. And I just want to give thanks to all the fathers out there. And I want to say thanks to my dad who passed away about 6 years ago.
We haven't been able to be here since we had our golf tournament fundraiser for Killing It for Creed, which we started in memory of our son, as many of you know. I just wanted to say that we raised thousands more than we did last year, and we went way above what we had hoped to get. So every year we grow, every year we help more kids, and so we're really thankful for that.
Amen.
And I want to celebrate our newest grandson, Barrett Dawson Head, was born May 25th. I don't think I've been up here to do this since he was born, and he's just growing like a little weed. And for all the fathers, whether you're a spiritual father or an actual father, but we celebrate you guys today.
God is good.
All the time.
All the time. That is good. In a minute, we're going to do our praise songs, and I want to give a disclaimer right now. Marshall's going to play for us on the first one, but on the second one, we're going to try a new experiment. Anthony left us some soundtracks to play, to sing by, and you know, it's pretty hard to do without a leader, so bear with us if we make mistakes. We're going to make a joyful noise for the Lord anyway. So if you would stand and sing with us, we'd appreciate it. Thank you.
Nothing on earth is as beautiful as you. Beautiful one I love, beautiful one I adore, beautiful one my soul must sing. Beautiful one I love, beautiful one I adore, beautiful one, my soul must sing. You opened my eyes to your wonders anew. You captured my heart with this love. 'Cause nothing on earth is as beautiful as you. You opened my eyes to your wonders anew. You captured my heart with this love. 'Cause nothing on earth is as beautiful as you.
Amen. Hey! Thank you. Good morning, church. If you would, please turn with me to Colossians chapter 3, verses 1 through 14. Colossians. It looks like Colossians. Chapter 3, 1 through 4. By the way, no one really, 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 truly knows how to pronounce ancient Greek, Koine Greek, just by the way. But we sure do get on to you if you say it wrong. But Colossians 1. So last night, I am working on the sermon and, just flipping through, and I saw something on Facebook. I watched this video called Modest is Hottest by Matthew West. Has anyone seen that? Nobody seen that? You have? It's pretty funny, isn't it, right? Modest is Hottest, and Matthew West is a Christian singer. I don't really know much about him, but it's about a dad singing to his daughters about being modest, right, in public. So he's talking about, what you wear. Now, I have 3 sons, so this really isn't an issue, right? And if you have daughters, you do you. But the point is, what you look at, what you look like, what you wear often tells something about yourself. And so here's this dad giving some advice. It's basically put this on, okay? He wants them to wear a turtleneck, right? A little more Amish, a lot less Kardashian. That's kind of the tagline, right? It's hilarious. So I want you to think about Paul saying, put on this. Because the Colossians have already put something off, taken something off. So today I'm going to talk about taking off our old clothes and putting new clothes on. We're talking about taking off our clothes. What y'all talking about in church? Taking off your clothes. And then we put something on. We put new clothes on. Beware of the sermon that only focuses on the former, right? Because Paul completes his idea. Has anyone worn the uniform? Has anybody? So veterans, right? Raise your hands, veterans, if you'd like to. When we say that, we know what that means, right? Has anyone worn the uniform, right? So we're probably talking about military, but it could be the police as well. What a uniform identifies yourself and to whom you belong. I went to military school. I never wore the uniform, but I had to wear a uniform for 2 years, right? And when I went to A&M, I said, no way, I'm going to the Corps. I'm going to be free. But I would have loved it if I had. I had a dream right after college, and I was in seminary. And it was kind of in that phase, like, what am I really going to do? Like, I think I know I'm called. I'm pretty sure I'm called to ministry. But, I remember, that night in my dorm at Asbury in Moore Hall, and I'm thinking, I just kind of like, Lord, wherever you want me to go. And I had this idea. I kind of wanted to go back to NIMI and be the chaplain. And I said, Lord, if you just want me to go now. Oh, by the way, they usually retire chaplains. They have degrees, masters of divinity and stuff like that. But here I was like 22 years old. And I was like, Lord, I'll do anything. I'll go anywhere, right? Just send me. If you want me to leave seminary, I'll go to NIMI right now. Well, that night, I had this dream, and guess where I was? Yeah, it was like the week before all the new cadets come and school starts up, and it's that week, it's called RAT week, Recruit at Training week, and that's where we get to have a lot of fun when you're you're the cadre, right? Well, I'm sitting there, and I've got my room all ordered, and I find my what to put on, my uniform, right? No. Wait a minute. Where's my uniform, right? So I'm looking for it. I can't find it. I'm starting to stress out. And I remember I called, you know, Nimmy and said, hey, I don't have my uniform. I'll come anyway. I'll be there, right? They said, no, you can't come. It was telling me that if I'm not ready, I can't do what Christ has called me to do. Remember when Paul talks about the Colossians? They are already on mission. They have already experienced Christ's salvation. But they have to remember to continue clothing themselves with the things of Christ. Okay, let's read. Since then, you have been raised with Christ. Set your hearts on things above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Set your minds on things above, not on earthly things. For you died, and your life is now hidden with Christ in God. When Christ, who is your life, appears, then you will also appear with him in glory. Put to death, execute, terminate. Put to death, therefore, whatever belongs to your earthly nature, your sin nature, right? Like sexual immorality, impurity, lust, evil desires, and greed, which is idolatry. Because of these, the wrath of God is coming. You used to walk in these ways in the life you once lived. But now you must rid yourselves of all such things as these: anger, rage, malice, slander, and filthy language from your lips. Do not lie to each other, since you have taken off your old self with its practices and have put on the new self, which is being renewed in the knowledge in the image of its creator. Here there is no Greek or Jew, circumcised or uncircumcised, barbarian, Scythian, slave or free, but Christ is all and is in all. Therefore, as God's chosen people, holy and dearly loved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. Bear with each other and forgive whatever grievances you may have against one another. Forgive as the Lord forgave you. And over all these virtues, put on love, which binds them all together in perfect unity. The word of the Lord for the people of God.
Thanks be to God.
I want to focus on just two, three points, okay? But we have a list, right? We have a list of vices, and we have a list of virtues. And Paul says, okay, you had an old life, now you are in this new life, right? You've said no to this, you've walked away from this, all of those vices, all of that sinful nature, right? We put that to death. And now you're walking in this new life, this freedom that is in Christ. But the idea is you have to keep on disciplining yourself. You have to keep on growing. And in fact, that's what's happening when Christ keeps renewing your mind. So there are vices that we can fall into. And there are virtues. There is a way that leads to death. And there is a way that leads to life. And the first thing we need to understand today, that Paul says, set your hearts. Set your hearts on things above, where Christ is seated at the right hand of God. Set your minds on things above, not on earthly things. So Paul wants us to fully dedicate our hearts and minds to Christ. He wants us to focus completely on Him. If our minds and our hearts are, metaphorically with Christ, it's going to change the way we see the world. It's going to change the way we respond. It's going to change the way we think. It's going to change the way we interact with one another. And it's absolutely supposed to, and it will, change the way we respond when others do things that, transgress against us, when we are sinned upon, when others cause us pain. If we set our hearts and our minds where Jesus is, we're going to see the world in a new way, right? It's just like getting new glasses, okay? I got new glasses today. The degree of my bifocals, those went up, right? Getting older every day. I remember the first time that I got glasses, yes, I was back at NIMI, and the professor said, "Brooks, read what's up on the board." And I said, no. All right, you don't say that there? And they're like, "What?" And I said, "I can't read it." And my friend Melissa, she says, "Here, try these." Everything changed. I saw everything clearly. I clearly saw everything. I saw them. I saw everything as it was. You see, when we look through the world, when we look to the world through the lens of Christ, we're not just seeing us, we're not just seeing the world for what it is. We're seeing the world for what it can be. So today, as you leave this place of worship, I want you to think, have I truly set my heart on Jesus Christ, where Christ is? And am I truly thinking about the things, spiritual things, holy things, Jesus things? Or am I thinking about things down here? The first time I ever realized this, I was back at NIMI. I'm going backwards, okay? And I made, confession, the sinner's prayer. Has anyone ever done that? I was alone in my dorm. And the next week, I was going to, I was getting ready. I was, putting my clothes on, my shirt, getting ready to go what? Start the weekend. It was Thursday, just to let you know. And I was about to go to the chicken or some, dance club or whatever. And I had this thought, okay, why don't you stay at home? And I thought, that's weird, right? I've never thought that before. But I went anyway, right? So the next week, guess what I'm doing? It's Thursday, the weekend, right? Friday really doesn't count. You just get through Friday. And I'm getting ready to go out, right? And I had this thought again. Why don't you just stay home and not go? I thought, wow, that's really strange. But I can go, right? I can go and I can just stay there and, have a beer, whatever, right? I was 21 by that time. And so I ignored that little voice. And I'm over at the Dixie Chicken. Who's been to the Dixie Chicken? It wasn't there, right? This is after some of you old acts. But we know, right? So I was sitting there doing what you do at the Dixie Chicken, and I was holding a beer, and I just realized at that moment, I'm not enjoying this at all. And I thought, that's strange. I've never not enjoyed the chicken. And I didn't even finish it. I went home, and the rest is history. And I distinctly remember The more I read Scripture, the more I thought about Jesus, the more I prayed, I actually said this, oh my goodness, I want to be like Jesus. I had heard the girls in my youth group say things like that when they came back from church camp, and I thought, that's weird, I've never thought about that. But at that moment, that important time, I actually said that. Do you want to be like Christ today? Because the gospel can renew your mind. And the more you set your heart on Christ and you think about that stuff instead of this stuff, the more your mind will be renewed. Paul says, get rid of all this kind of vice. And we don't have to go through that list again. You know, for me, it's like anger, right? I can get angry really quickly, and I have to watch that, right? For me, I can have a beer or two, but after that, I gotta stop, right? Because I know what happens after that. But more important than that list is the list he's about to share. We've killed the vices. They're like ticks, they're fleas. We've taken a bath, we've killed them, we've pulled them off. And now he says, clothe yourself, dearly beloved, clothe yourselves with compassion, kindness, humility, gentleness, and patience. Bear with each other and forgive whatever grievances you may have against one another. Forgive as the Lord forgave you. And over all these virtues, put on love, which binds them all together in perfect unity. The word of God for the people of God. Who's this remind you of? Who? This could be a description of who? Yeah, Jesus. When you hear these characteristics, these virtues, is this not what Christ has shown us? So Paul could very well said, clothe yourselves. Be Jesus every day. Not just to the world, but especially his focus is not being Jesus to the world. His specific focus is you being this type of person, this type of Christian. These characteristics to your brothers and sisters in Christ. Now we often think, right? Preachers want us to go there, right? Let's go out there. Why? Because if we're not out there, we're not what as a church? We're not growing. Serving, that's like what we want you to do. But I promise you, there's this fear that we're not going to grow. And what happens if you don't grow? You die, but before that, the money goes down, right? Man, I've been in this pattern so many times over 16 years or so, but it's amazing. Every time I think about that earthly thing, if a family gets mad and leaves with me, and I'm like, oh my gosh, there goes my month. Guess what? In a month or two, someone comes. I've seen it over and over and over. And guess what? They're a better servant. And guess what? They usually give more. And it might be two or three. And the world is served. Paul wants you to specifically focus on one another. Because what we do in here makes a difference out there. And if we're transformed in here, if we are living like Christ to one another, we will be transformed out there. And I promise you, what you do out here, out there, matters in here. I just want to share with you just two things. Paul says, clothe yourselves. Compassion. Anyone know what, like, if you broke it down into Greek, what is that? What's the root word? Compassion, right? And we always think about it, woo, 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 yeah, passionate, right, about the things you love, right? Am I not like a passionate Aggie? Yeah, like you're gonna hear that over and over and over with me, right? It's like 75 days till kickoff, right? And we always think, let's get excited. Come on, guys. And you know what, church? If you're just passionate, how many preachers, how many like church things have you heard in your lifetime saying, if you're not passionate, you're not gonna grow. And if you get passionate, church, if you get excited, church, guess what's gonna happen? People are gonna see it and you're gonna grow. Have you heard something like that? If not that exact message? And I used to believe that, and to some degree it's true. The conferences said it was true, right? All the continuing education said it was true. That speaker we flew in for several thousand dollars at annual conference, oh yeah, they said it was true. Our church is growing. Oh yeah, because we're passionate. Anyone know what compassion really means, or passion? It means to suffer. Paul isn't saying, oh yeah, be compassionate, right? Be passionate here. Be really excited with one another, right? Because we're the church and we've got such a great message. We do. Do we not? Do we not? What he's saying here is suffer with one another. Who suffered with us? Who suffered for us? Say it. That's right. Just be Jesus. Just think about the Jesus stuff. Just think about it. You set your mind on suffering with one another, suffering for one another, giving yourself, making yourself less. Guys, that is part of the secret. Paul says, bear each other's burdens. Does that mean carry everything for the other person? He says, bear it. Help them. Help people in your church. Bear with them their emotional traumas. And I've seen that. Have we not? I've seen that over and over in this church. But it doesn't mean enable. We don't have to talk about that. You see, when you suffer with people because you love that people, you can't help helping them. Can you? Yes or no, church? It's just who you are, right? Because when your mind's set on Christ and your heart's up there bearing one another, just makes sense. Does it not? What we do in here makes a difference. Because everything we do in here as a community makes a difference out there. I got one more week. Just like that, is it not? You think about 1 week of church, I think about one year of church, right? This has been such a blessing to me. And I'm not going to do like the last sermon the week before, et cetera, et cetera. It's been one incredible year for me. But you know what? When you think about that year, you probably think about being in the church, right? And serving. All I think about is 1 year of writing a dissertation and how I don't have that year back. I only have about 60 days. What has been my thought for over 9 years? Only one half of a day has gone by in over 9 years that I did not think about old dissertina, my affair. It is so difficult right now just to trust God and put my mind up there. I don't like talking about myself or whatever. That's my cross to bear right now. And if I don't do it, I don't think I pass it or complete it. Is your heart with Christ? because Christ has set it apart. Is it holy? Or you let the stuff just, get on you, you wear it. Take that stuff off. Kill the ticks. Kill the mosquitoes. Repel them with your love. Repel the enemies of the church with your love and your community and your service to one another. And that, I can promise you, is the secret of a healthy church. You are a healthy church. You will be, in Jesus' name, a healthy church. You have strong leadership going forward indefinitely. You are a healthy church. Stand up, healthy church. Stand up, stand up. Say it. We are a healthy church.
We are a healthy church.
Because.
Become
healthy. I'm going to start over, right? We are a healthy church.
We are a healthy church.
Because.
Because.
We love each other.
We love each other.
And we want everybody.
We want everybody.
Be loved in the same way.
Be loved in the same way.
That's it, folks. Remain standing and we'll sing. Let's pray. Let's intercede for our church right now. As the musicians come forward. Great triune God. We thank you because only in your name and your transforming grace by faith, we can say such a thing. We know we are not complete. We know we are not perfect. We know there is so much more potential. Our level of service hasn't even come close to maxing out. But we remember what Paul is doing. And if he mentions negative stuff and then positive stuff, Lord Jesus, we know he's speaking to a church then that is ready to go. But they just need a little more help from the Holy Spirit every day. Pray with me. Come, Holy Spirit.
Come, Holy
baptize
Spirit.
Us
baptize us.
In your presence.
In your presence.
Renew our minds.
Renew our minds.
In Jesus' name.
In Jesus' name.
Amen.
Amen.
Let's worship. Who chose that?
I'm sure.
I didn't.
Terry.
Wow.
I don't know.
Is that not a coincidence or what?
It's a God thing.
See, some of you are thinking, I don't know what you're talking about, right? Well, hey, it's on video. Or you can listen to it. You want to play an oldie buddy goodie?
Okay.
If it Marshall can pull up the oldie.
March, let's be 668.
No, that's not playing.
That's not playing.
Let us now depart in thy peace, blessed Jesus. Send us to our homes with God's love in our hearts. Let not the busy world claim all our loyalties. Keep us ever mindful, dear Lord, of thee.
Benediction. We seek your kingdom. Go to the slide right before that, please.